Today I am going to give a lecture on biomass conversion technology. In this lecture, history of a small producer gas engine system, gasification process and its chemistry we are going to learn. The content of the lecture includes the introduction to the gasification, history of the gasification process, characteristics of the feedstock, chemistry of a gasification, classification of a gasification, advantages and disadvantages of gasifiers, various gasifiers, engine adoption and operation. Here we are going to see the Breton cycle. So in the first hours, the four topics, that is introduction, history, classification of a, gasification process, characteristics of the feedstock, we are going to first learn. Dear students, by seeing this figure, what it is understood? It is a day-to-day application life, that is, the gas is produced. Say for instance, the producer gas from the your motorbike, which carries the potential energy sufficient to produce again alternative mechanical form, which can be whatever the gas exhausted from your motorcycle silencer. So here you can see the from the low volume to high volume, the pressure will be built up, and when it is exhausted, it is comes with a high pressure with a low volume, and as a result it will be easily reaped its kinetic energy in the form of, here it is in the form of a small turbine can be run. In turn, the small turbine is connected to the generator to produce the electricity, or it can be used for some other applications. So this is the conceptual introduction to your gasification process. Here the gas, producer gas, comes out of the silencer, and it can be very useful to convert in terms of the mechanical energy. Okay, right. The forest biomass represents, the alternative source of the fossil fuels. So here in this figure, you can see 2,230 million tons oil equivalents per year. Without deforestation, you can produce 2,230 million tons of oil equivalents per year, which is approximately equals to the 22% of the world energy needs can be met from the biomass without deforestation. Okay, in this roadmap, all the developed countries, you can see southern America, and then these European countries, and then when it comes to Indian countries also, we are adopting the alternative resources for the fossil fuel, that is a renewable energy, which comes out not only from the this is a picture of the only from the what it is stated, that is a forest biomass. Apart from the forest biomass, as we have seen in the previous lectures, so apart from the forest, that is a woody biomass, so we are getting an equivalent and double amount of the energy potential biomass from the agricultural and solid municipal waste. Okay, so that is the potentiality of the biomass, which has to be, if it is utilized in a proper direction, we can reap in a huge potential energy deficit in the growing population, right? So the history of the gasification process. So in the history, we'll see in two sectors, that is the budding experimental stages of the gasification process, and then its application process of the gasification. In the experimental process, see, in the 1669, Thomas Shirley conducted the crude experiment with the carbureted hydrogen, and to run the mechanical machines. After him, after the 30 years of the gap, Dean Clayton obtained a coal and peat gas. The coal is it is a form of fossil fuel, whereas the peat is a biomass based fuel resource, from which he has pyrolytic experiment has been conducted to produce the pyrolytic gases, right? In the experimental stages, the first patent was regarded to the gasifier. Gasification was issued to the two members separately, that is Robert Gardner and John Barber, in the year 1788 and 1791. Okay, Robert Gardner, so he has claimed for patent the suggested application of the waste heat of the furnaces. Here the waste heat of the furnaces, as you have seen the motorbike heat, the waste heat of the furnaces to raise the steam by combustion, the heated product in the boiler. So this is one of the patented obtained by the gasification process by the Robert Gardner, that is the waste heat of the furnaces he has utilized to raise the steam. So by raising the steam, we can run the generators, turbines, and by then we can produce any electricity. For that he has obtained the patent on the gasification process. So similarly, the John Barber patent mentioned the use of the producer gas to drive the internal combustion engine. He is the first person to introduce the producer gas application in the combustion in internal combustion IC engines, we can say way back to 1792. That's 1792. Well, the experiments to gasify the woody are at least use of the gases obtained from the charring of the woods started surprisingly early at this night. So later on there were any progressions in the development of the gasification process. In the 1800, the charring of the woods was used to develop the gases, that is a producer gas. In 1815, the major cities of the world had a gas lights, which has been, the gas has been generated from the gasification process. About in 1880, so after the gas lights has been introduced, the same producer gas has been used for an internal combustion engine. In the 19th century, they have invented the producer gas, the name it is known as the producer gas, and to make the electricity. So early developments of the gasification. So when it comes to any gasification was discovered independently by the both France as well as the England in the 1798. So after the experimental stages have been passed out, then the discoveries has been come into the play to claim that their role in the progress of the gasification was the France and England in the 1700s and 1800s years to develop, mainly because of the lighting the lamps in the form of the producer gas, which has been produced mainly from the coal. So then during the World Wars, during the First World War, the small gasifier was developed around the utilization of the natural resources, that's the charcoal as well as the biomass feedstock, to operate the vehicles, boats and train, etc. So between the two World Wars, there was a tremendous scope for emphasis was given to develop the gasifier based the producer gas, as it was a very inexpensive and simpler and easy available due to the crisis of the gasoline scarcity. So at the beginning of the World War II, there was a great scarcity was there for alternative fuel to be searched off. By 1943, the Sweden country, so 90% of the vehicle, the Sweden, which is a frontier to do the experiments and the adoption of the gasifier based the technology, the 90% of the vehicles in the Sweden were powered by the gasifiers, and they were using the excellently using this gasification technology to run the almost small to the bigger level of the vehicles in the road. Whereas nowadays the interest of the small gasifiers is strong among the developing countries as well as the developed countries. So when it comes to any continental wise, it is they are reporting that Europe Europe has been exploiting the most of the gas fire technology, as it was stated that the Sweden during the World War II, their frontier to produce and produce gas through the gasification process using the wood and charcoal. So even America subcontinent also claims that work related to the producer gas engines. So as per the Totem, they are reporting that working on the gasoline truck engines, they were stating that they are claiming that their work done the gasoline truck engines with a simulated pyrolysis gas at the derating of 60% to 65%, whereas similarly in Indian context also, the IIT Mumbai, so as per the Shashikant and et al, Parikar et al, they are reporting that the gas engines converted from the natural aspirated diesel engines, they are converting it and they are run at the compression ratio of 11.5. so this is about the brief history of the gasification process. So gasification process, we'll see the what is the gasification. So gasification is, it's a thermochemical process which converts the biomass material into the gaseous compounds. The resultant gasification is a producer gas. So even we can state it as a syngas. What is the major difference between the producer gas, syngas? Is the syngas is the major mixture of the other components than that of the combustible gases, whereas the producer gas mainly, which is consist of the combustible gas components. Here the producer gas, which is containing the carbon monoxide, hydrogen, methane and the carbon dioxide. Here the carbon dioxide is impurity. It is a non-combustible gas molecule. Okay, then when it comes to biomass gasification, there are two ways of gasification. As you see in the coal gasification, in the early stage of the gasification histories, we can see the coal gasification was in a gasification process. The strategy of a formation of the producer gas in with respect to the coal gasification is different than that of the biomass gasification. Okay, the biomass is more reactive and having the high volatile component. Unlike the coal gasification process, the gasification occurs at the low temperatures in case of the biomass, whereas it has a lower sulfur content, whereas in coal gasification, coal is having a higher sulfur content. But in case of a biomass, it is having a higher alkali content. Alkalis are here the sodium and potassium content, which can cause the slagging and falling problems during the gasification process. We'll see what is the slagging, what's the falling. Okay, in the next slides. Okay, gasification process, we get the output as a producer gas, which is not in the purified form, but it needs to be cleaned to remove mainly the tar, which is a volatile compound, and other contaminants, mainly these alkalis, the sodium and potassium, which tends to reduce the calories of the producer gas. So therefore, there is a need to remove these components from the producer gas in order to increase its efficiency for conversion of the mechanism. Okay, the producer the biomass gasification can be broadly classified into the three segments, let's say upstream processing, downstream processing and the gasification process. The upstream processing, it is a pre processing, and downstream processing, it is a post processing. In the pre processing, whatever the feedstock we are going to feed to the gasifier is a pre processing. So maybe moisture content, here you can see the size reduction, drying, moisture content, ash content, all those parameters has to be worked out for any different types of gasifiers to be best output, to be best output in terms of the producer gas. Whereas in case of the downstream, that is a post processing, which includes, so whatever here we have seen the producer gas after gasification process we are getting, it has to be further subjected for a cleaning to remove the impurities to make it as a high efficient. Okay, then the gasification process, which includes the four segments, that's a heating, chemical reaction and catalytic reactions. Okay, we'll see in detail about that thing. So as I stated that the upstream processing, here you can see the upstream processing the particle size reduction, the densification and the drying and densification. So these are all these three important parameters of the feedstock. So apart from this, there are other parameters, we'll see the feed characteristics. So biomass
particle sizes, the various particles having the various adaptability to the various gasifiers. Okay, the smaller on whole, the smaller the particle, its surface area will be increased. As a result of that, the heat transfer for any production of gas, that is a producer gas, can be enhanced by reducing the particle size. The smaller particles results in the more combustible gases like any methane and other hydrocarbons and carbon. So for reducing the particles, commonly they are using the hammers, knife mills, tub grinder. After the grinding process, they will be screened out and they will subjected for an densification process. So once it has been size reduction, then the biomass will be subjected for a drying process. In this drying process, there is no separate stream of dryers or heat source will be utilized. Waste heat of the gasifiers can also be utilized for a drying of the feedstock, which is used for any gasification process. And various types of a drying mechanism, bin dryer, band dryer, and rotary cascade dryers can be used. And densification process, when it comes to a densification, so in agricultural, in biomass, when it comes to in a biomass, we have in a high density and low density biomasses. Both the biomasses can be used to gasify to produce the producer gas, but the type of a gasifier choosing for a low density and high density is varying. So low density fuels present problems in the gasifiers, and hence the it has to be densified and it has to be made with the pellets. In general, these slides briefly explains that difference between the gasifier efficiency and the direct combustion efficiency with respect to the electrical efficiency, fuel to electrical efficiency. So here the 35% to 45% is the gasification fuel to electricity efficiency, and the direct combustion process, which is 10% to 25%. See, students, this biomass conversion, though I have shared the material, the biomass can be converted into the various energy sources, various means of the conversion process. So one among them is a biological and thermochemical process, we can say it as. In the biological, we have seen the biogas production is one of the prominent in the agriculture, whereas the ethanol production is other source of other way of the production of the ethanol for any diesel production. And when it comes to any chemical conversion process, this gasification, direct combustion, and pyrolysis comes in under the thermochemical conversion process. So among these, the fuel to electricity efficiency, they are comparing over here. So it's a more economical to be practiced, right? The characteristics of the feedstock, as I told, that the moisture content, ash content, and bulk density and the particle sizes are the more prominent characteristics of the feedstock to be produce the highest producer gas without the tar composition and the particle composition, that is a dust composition, to yield the high net calorific value, right? So here in this particular slide table, we can see there is a clear cut comparison between the updraft. These two are the types of a gasifiers. So apart from this, we'll see the another two types of a gasifier in the next forthcoming slides. So they are compared with the agriculture feedstock, that is a rice husk and wood and bamboos. So you can net calorific value for both gasifiers, it needs to be higher for a better output, the better efficiency. The moisture content adaptability, for as I told, the moisture content is a measure, but the type of the gasifier varies. For updraft gasifiers, you can up to the 50% of the moisture content can be subjected to a gasification process, whereas downdraft, updraft gasifier, so 15% to 20%, whereas ash content is another functional character, we can say, because of, as I told, that the slagging and fouling. So this is ash is the major ill parameter, we can say the other side, it's a detrimental parameter. If the ash content of the feedstock is more, then there will be more slagging and more, that's a formation of the ash layer over your char, that's a the burning char, so which reduces the heat transfer between the your char to your producer gas. That's a cracking during a cracking process that impairs the conversion process. Okay, so if you use the updraft gasifier, the 15% of the less than 15% of the ash content can be adaptable, but in downdraft gasifier it is a less than 4-5%. In general, dear students, generally talking, the ash content of the feedstock should be less than the 4% as it is stated in a theory, so many of the theory books. Okay, then the bulk density, I'll talk about the ash fusion temperature later. The bulk density more than 400 kgs per meter cube is acceptable for the updraft gasifier, whereas the downdraft gasifier, it should be more denser, that's a greater than the 500 kgs per meter cube for it, because it is producing more higher quality producer gas. I'll tell you when it comes to an explanation, right? Then the particle sizes, the pellet size which has to be ranges from the 5 to 100 mm, that means point the 5 to 100 mm size particles pellet size can be utilized for the updraft gasifier, whereas the particle sizes, whereas the pellet size can be little higher for the downdraft gasifier. So here you can see the respective characteristics, feed characteristics, different feed characteristics. Here the bamboo wood is having the high net calorific value. So apart from these parameters, I'll tell you there is a carbon C content of these producers, these biomass feedstock also plays very pivotal role. So apart from these parameters, so next to that, we'll see what is the ash fusion temperature, right? So the ash fusion temperature for the both cases is greater than, because the ash which is fuses at more than the 1250 degrees Celsius. So if the ash content is more, then the layers of the ash will be more over the red coke, which impairs the heat transmission between the red coke to the producer gas in order to crack the reactions. The cracking reactions we'll see in the gasification zone in case of the gasifiers, various types of gasifiers. So lesser the ash, then this ash fusion temperature probably can be in a lesser quantity. Well, students, with this I will wind up this hour of the lecture. That is, so whatever we have covered is the introduction to gasification. So it has been started with the introducing the what is the gas. You have to understand very clearly. So the gas which is comes out of the your silencer, the bike silencer, which is also gas, which can also be termed as the gas which is having an energy composition. So not only carbon dioxide it is having, it also has in a combustible gas which is carbon monoxide, as well as the heat which can be used as an example to explain the gasification process. And then what is the history of the gasification process. So we have started with the experimental stage of the gasification, which starts with the coals and followed by a peat. Then it is slowly, steadily, the gas, producer gas was produced using the biomasses mainly, and to lit the lamps, and later stages it has been employed for running in a small and larger vehicles during the World Wars of I and World War of II. And even in the World War of II, there was a lot of a scarcity of the fossil fuel. So therefore the Sweden country, almost 90% of the vehicles were running based upon the gasifiers, right? So what is the gasification process? The brief introduction of the gasification is thermochemical conversion process in the presence of the oxygen, we can state it as. So by gasification process, we will get an introduce as an producer gas. Right, then rest of the things, the comparison between the thermochemical process, that's a combustion with respect to the gasification, we have learned. And then the characteristic of the food feed stack. So whatever the feed which we are subjecting for a gasification process, we should know the its important characteristic producing the maximum efficiency of the producer gas, right? So in the next class, we'll see these things. Okay, with this, I'll wind up this hour and we'll see in the next hour. Thank you.